हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, मायसेल्फ नारायण चौड़े फ्रॉम एल के आर एफ प्रिंस इंग्लिश सीबीएसई स्कूल सेलू डिस्ट्रिक्ट परभणी। टुडे वी आर डिस्कसिंग फ्रॉम द बायोलॉजी द चैप्टर नेम इज द सेम द फंडामेंटल यूनिट ऑफ लाइफ। इन दिस चैप्टर टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट फ्रॉम द इंट्रोडक्शन, देन आफ्टर दैट डेफिनेशन ऑफ द सेल, डिस्कवरी ऑफ द सेल, देन सेल शेप्स, देयर साइजेस, देयर नंबर्स एंड आफ्टर द पार्ट्स ऑफ द सेल एंड ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ दैट we'll discuss on the basis difference between plant cell and the animal cell. So in this introduction we know that in our solar system earth is the only planet that we call as the living planet. Why it is called as living planet? Because yes, on earth living organisms are there, and yes, we know that in living organisms, suppose take example of animals, take example of plants, in between that we see the variety on the basis of that in their habitats, variety in their occurrence, variety in their structure, body parts, in their behavior. So on the basis of that, suppose see here living organisms, and these living organisms, we know that the body of living organism, yes, how it is made. Suppose take example of human beings having, suppose take example human beings having hands, human beings having nose, human beings having eyes, human beings having legs, and also these are the external organs we can say, and likewise the organs present inside the body also. We know that human having the brain, likewise they having the digestive system, they having the respiratory system, they having so many that internal organs. So that human having external organ as well as the means internal organs. So basically we can say that any living organisms, their body, yes, it is made up from the their parts, or that we call as the organs. And yes, these organs, yes, working in the system format. Okay, but see, these organs are made up from the tissues, and these tissues are made up from the cells. So on the basis of this, yes, we definitely, yes, it is called as the, yes, cell is the fundamental unit, as well as it is called as the structural unit, as well as it is called as the functional unit. So group of the cell, a single cell, when came together many cell, then they form a tissue, or they form a tissue. We know that when these tissues came together and to perform a function, single function in a system manner, then they form an organ system or the organ. And when this organ system came together, then they form the living organism's body. They form the living organism's body. So for the living organism, for their structure, so cell is the basic unit. So along with that basic structural unit, cell is also called as the functional unit. Why? Because any function performed by the living organism's body, any function performed by the living organism body, it is nothing but the result of the activity of the cells. Yes, so it is nothing but the result of activity of the cell. So means the definition of the cell, how we suppose define the definition of the cell, see here, cell is the structural and functional unit of life, as well as we can say here structural and functional unit of living organism. Yes, it is very simple definition. Cell is the structural and the functional unit of living organisms. Okay, now after this definition of the cell, we'll discuss the next point, and that we call as the discovery of the cell. Now we'll discuss the discovery of the cell. That is our third point. See, first, who discovered the cell? Yes, it is discovered by the well-known scientist that we call as the Robert Hooke in the year, that is 1665. But we know that how Robert Hooke in the year 1665 discovered the cell, because cell is not naked to our eyes. It is so microscopic. So how that Robert Hooke discovered the cell. And yes, till 1665, there is no any discovery of microscope. Yes, microscope is the instrument where we observe the that structure of the cell. Then how Robert Hooke discovered the that cell in 1665? So here detailed suppose report of the Robert Hooke is that Robert Hooke made their own self designed microscope, and this microscope, it is the combination of two lenses only. It is a combination of two lenses, and which are temporary. Yes, and under his self designed microscope, he observed a thin slice of cord, or we can say simply a separated part of the plant that is called as the tree, that is called as the cool. Means when he observed under his self designed microscope, this is the thin slice of the cord. So their observation he explained like that, he observed a empty compartment. He also described this empty compartment as a little rooms, but these are the little rooms showing the structure of honeycomb like structure. You know that honeycomb? So honeycomb like structure. And yes, after his description about that is the empty compartments or the little rooms, but in Latin language these cella that we in our English language that we call as the little rooms or the empty compartments. And after his discovery that cella means little room, yes, now we call as the that microscopic and also the basic fundamental unit of the life or the living organism, that we call as the cell. Okay, so after this discovery, that is the discovery of the cell, but these cells, Robert Hooke, those he observed his under microscope, these cells are the dead cells are, because it is a separated part of the tree, that we call as the thin slice of the core, or that we also call as the bark of the tree. So first discovered cells are the dead. Okay, now see, after 1665, yes, again that one well known scientist came, that is Anton von Leeuwenhoek. He came and he further modified the structure of their Robert Hooke microscope. And yes, after that, after modification, that Anton Leeuwenhoek microscope, yes, that 275 times, yes, it is modified and also the zooming the structure of the cell for the detailed study. So it is also one of the evolutionary things for the, that is the microscopic world. Now after this point, that is the discovery of the cell, yes, we discuss the cell shapes, sizes and the numbers. We know that, again we will take example of human body only. Yes, we know that in human body RBC cells are there, their cells, their shapes are the oval shape. Again we will discuss the nerve cell, which is the thread like, or we can say the wire like structure. Yes, again we will discuss suppose muscle cell, which is the spindle shape. Means each and every location of the human body, and yes, in their location on the basis of their functions, their shapes are the different one. Though cell shapes are the different one, which is on the basis of their functions, Now on the basis of their numbers, yes, see here, we'll categorize, that is one is single cell organism, that we call as the unicellular organism, and more than one cell, the organism which consists, that we call as the multicellular organism. Now when we categorize this one, so in unicellular organism only one cell is present, and here in many cells are present. Again see, in single cell only, in unicellular organism, all the functions are carried out, in a single cell. But here in multicellular cell, for each and every functions different cells are working, So on the basis of this, we can say in multicellular organism, division of labor is there, but here division of labor is completely absent because all the functions performed by the single cell only. Okay, now we'll discuss the parts of the cell and as well as the difference between the plant cell and the animal cell. Yes, here are the simple diagrams that I drawn. See, first you see the shape of the cell. Yes, it is somewhat circular, and in plant cell it is somewhat, yes, it is a rectangular shape, or it is not a circular. So that is the main difference. Again, see here, in animal cell nucleus is at the center. Nucleus, yes, it is at the center, but in plant cell nucleus is not at the center and it is displaced either side of the cell due to the big size of the vacuole. So these are the vacuoles which are the big in size, but these vacuoles in animal cells are in small size. These vacuoles are the small size. Again, see here, in addition of that, we know that in plant having green colors, that is of the leaf. Again, that some suppose stems also green in color, flowers having a different color, again fruits also having a different color, that raw fruits are the green in color, again after maturation again they having the respective colors, and it is due to only the presence of plastids. And these plastids, yes, it is what are the color pigments, and these plastids are absent in the animal cells. Okay, again one more suppose here distinguish. See here cell membrane is also there, and this cell membrane present in plant cell also there. Okay, this is the cell membrane, but see here one additional protective layer is present in the plant cell, and that is called as the cell wall. And cell wall, yes, it is made up from the cellulose, and this cell wall, it is not present in the animal cell. So here cell wall is absent. So that's why that animal's body, yes, it is a flexible, or we can say the soft body, as compared to the plant body, because plant's body is very much rigid and tough layer, because cell wall is a, we can say it is a non-living substance, and here cell membrane, yes, it is a living one. So that's why animal cell is a smooth, soft, and plant cell outer mostly, yes, it is a rigid and also the tough nature.